Good morning, students. This is Shanbhagap Iya, Assistant Professor of Mathematics, St. Anne's Arts and Science College. Welcome you all to this new academic year 2020-21. I am going to handle the allied subject Statistics 1. In this PPT, I am going to cover the following topics. Introduction, basic definitions, measures of central tendency, mean and median, simple problems. This is the syllabus. Here, the first two units are theory parts. Today, I am going to start from the third unit. Introduction. Introduction. Statistics is a subject that deals with numerical facts and figures. Statistics is a mathematical science including methods of collecting, organizing and analyzing data in such a way that meaningful conclusions can be drawn from them. In general, its investigations and analysis falls into two broad categories called descriptive and inferential statistics. Statistics is defined as a collection, organization, presentation, analysis, and interpretation of numerical data. For example, statistics is used to record the property, wealth, taxes, birth, death, etc. by the government. It is used in various other fields like business, economics, education and science, etc. So, it was described as science of kings. Today, we are going to start from the Unit 3, Measures of Central Tendency. Measures of Central Tendency are also usually called as averages. They give us an idea about the concentration of the values in the central part of the distribution. The following are the five measures of central tendency that are in common use: arithmetic mean, median, mode, geometric mean, harmonic mean. First one is arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean is the most used measure of averages. So, it is also called as average. Here, three methods are there. First one, for individual observation, that is raw data or ungrouped data. If x1, x2, x3, etc., xn are n observations of the series, then arithmetic mean is denoted by x bar, is given by x bar is equal to summation x by n. This is the formula for finding mean, that is equal to summation x, that we have to add all the observations x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus etc. plus xn divided by n. This is the formula for ungrouped data. Then second method, for grouped data, frequency data, that means discrete data. The formula for finding arithmetic mean is x bar is equal to summation fx by summation f or summation fx by capital N. We can denote this summation f as capital N. Next, continuous data, grouped data. The formula for finding arithmetic mean is x bar is equal to a plus summation fd by capital N into c, where a is assumed mean, d equal to x minus a by c, and capital N is equal to summation f total frequency, c is the class limit. For this grouped data, we can use this formula also. This is the direct formula. X bar is equal to summation fx by summation f. First problem, ungrouped data, that is raw data. The marks obtained by 10 students in a class are 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 30, 40, 50, 60, 90. Calculate the arithmetic mean. Here, for ungrouped data, the formula is x bar is equal to summation x by n. We had to add all the observations and divide by the number of observations. Here, the number is given 10. 10 students marks. So, divide by 10. N equal to small n equal to 10. If we add all the observation, we will get the value 570 divide by 10. Then the mean value is x bar is equal to 57. This is the answer. Then second type is discrete type. Discrete type, wages are given and the frequency. Frequency means number of workers. 125, 135, 145, 155, 165, 175, 185, 195, frequency 8, 24, 52, 70, 58, 39, 28, 24. X is the wages and F is the frequency. Here we can take that as first column X, the given values, and second column. Second column is the frequency. We have to multiply these two. We have to find the Fx value. 125 into x equal to 1000, 135 into 24 is equal to 3240, 145 into 52 is equal to 7540, 155 into 70 is equal to 10850, 165 into 58 is equal to 9570, 175 into 39 is equal to 6825, 185 into 28 is equal to 5180, 195 into 21 is equal to 4095. Here we have to find summation F, that is capital N, that is equal to 300. Add all the values, so we will get 300. The same way we have to find summation Fx. Here the mistakes, we have to write the summation Fx, that is equal to 48,300. So arithmetic mean formula is x bar is equal to summation Fx by summation F, that is equal to 48,300 divided by 300, that is equal to 161. This is the answer for this question. Next type, continuous type. Calculate mean of the following data. Marks and number of students is given. Solution, we can apply the direct method. Mean value is equal to summation Fx by summation F. First draw the tabular column, then first column is CI, class interval, second column frequency, and third one we have to find the mid value of X. First two columns are given in the question, and third column we have to find that mid value of X, mid value of the class interval. So mid value of 0 to 10 is 5, mid value of 10 to 20, middle value, that is middle value, is 15. Middle value of 20 to 30 is 25. Middle value of 30 to 40 is 35. And middle value of 40 to 50 is 45. Otherwise, we can add these two numbers and divide by 2, we will get this answer. 0 plus 10 is 10. 10 divided by 2, 5. 10 plus 20 is 30. 30 divided by 2 is 15. Like that, we can find this column. The next column, F into X. We have to multiply F and X. This is F value and X value. First row, 7 into 5, 35. 12 into 15, 180. 24 into 25, 600. 10 into 35, 350. 7 into 45, 315. Then we have to find the total frequency. Total frequency, we have to add all this. Frequency, then we'll get 60. This is summation F. Then we have to find summation Fx. We have to add all these values, we'll get 1480. Then we can apply the direct formula. Mean X bar is equal to summation Fx by summation F. Then summation Fx 1480 and summation F 60. If we divide this, we'll get 24.666, it is going on. We can take the two digits. 24.66, the third digit also 6. So above 5, we can add 1 to the second digit. So we'll get 24.67. This is the answer. The same problem we can apply in this formula also, deviation formula. Calculate mean of the following data, the same previous question only. Then we can apply in this method. In this formula, x bar is equal to a plus summation fd by n into c. Here d is the deviation. That formula is x minus a by c. A is the assumed mean and c is the class size. Class size means that intervals, the length of the interval, 0 to 10, the length is 10. 10 to 20, the length is 10. So c is equal to 10. So first two columns is given in the question itself, ci and frequency, and third column we have to find the middle value of the class interval, that is x. So the, by the previous same as the previous sum, we can find middle value of x. The middle value of 0 to 10 is 5, and the middle value of 10 to 20 is 15, and the middle value of 20 to 30 is 25, middle value of 30 to 40 is 35, middle value of 40 to 50 is 45. Next column, we have to find d. D is equal to x minus a by c. Here, x is 5 and the assumed mean we can take that as 25. So, 5 minus 25, that is equal to minus 20 divided by c value is 10. So, minus 20 by 10 is minus 2. The same way, next column, 15 minus 25, that is minus 10, divided by 10 is equal to minus 1. Then next, third row, 25 minus 25 is 0, 0 divided by 10 is 0. The fourth row, 35 minus 25 is 10, divided by 10 is 1. Then fifth row, 45 minus 25 is 20, divided by 10 is equal to 2. Then last fifth column, we have to find f into d. We can multiply f into d. Second column into fourth column. So 7 into minus 2 equal to minus 14. 12 into minus 1 is equal to minus 12. 24 into 0 is equal to 0. 10 into 1 is equal to 10. 7 into 2 is equal to 14. Now we have to find the summation f. That is capital N is equal to 60 and summation FD, that is equal to minus 2. Here the value, if we add all the observations, we will get minus 2. Then we can apply in this formula, X bar is equal to A plus summation FD divided by N into C. Here A value is 25 plus summation FD minus 2 divided by capital N value is 60 into C value 10, that is equal to 25 plus minus 2 into 10 is minus 20 divided by 60, that is equal to 25 minus 20 divided by 60, the value is 0.3333 is going on, we can take 4 digits, then that is equal to 24.6667, we can take 2 digits also, so 24.67, that is the answer. We are going to find the median if the observations are arranged in ascending or descending order, then the middlemost item is called median. Here also three types, first type raw data, second type discrete data, third type continuous data. First type, if n is odd, that is the number of observations is odd, then for finding median, the formula is m is equal to n plus 1 divided by 2th item. And in the another case, if n is even, the number of observation is even, then median is equal to n by 2th item plus n by 2 plus 1th item divided by 2. The same way, second method, discrete data. If same way, two types, if n is odd, median m is equal to n plus 1 by 2th item. And if n is even, median m is equal to n by 2th item plus n by 2 plus 1th item divided by 2. Then third part, continuous data, median m is equal to l plus n by 2 minus m divided by f into c. where L is the lower limit of the median class, N is the total frequency, that is summation F, F is the frequency of the median class, and M is the cumulative frequency of the pre-median class, C is the class limit. Next, problems. Problems for ungrouped data, raw data. Find the median of 5, 3, 8, 4, 7, 9, 11. In this, first we have to arrange these observations in ascending order. 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 11. Next, we have to find n. N values. How many observations are given here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 observations. So, n is equal to 7. This is the odd number. So, we have to apply the first formula. Median value m equal to n plus 1 divided by 2th item. That is equal to 7 plus 1 divided by 2th item. 2 equal to 8 by 2. That is equal to 4th item. Here, the 4th number is 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth number is 7. So, the answer is 7. So, median value is 7. Second question. Find the median of 31, 35, 40, 52, 60, 65. Here, the number of observations 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number of observation is even. Always will first we have to arrange numbers in ascending order. So, 31, 35, 40, 52, 60, 65. Then, the formula for finding median is m is equal to n by 2th item plus n by 2 plus 1th item divided by 2. Here, n is 6. So, 6 by 2 plus 6 by 2 plus 1 divided by 2. Here, 3rd and 4th item divided by 2. 3rd value. Find this 3rd value from this arrangement. 1, 2, 3. 3rd value is 40 and 4th value is 52. So, 40 plus 52 divided by 2 equal to 46. So, the answer is 46. Next, discrete type, calculate the median. Wages and number of workers is given. We have to find the table first. We have to find the cumulative frequency here. First, X value and F value are given in this table. Then, third column, we have to find the cumulative frequency. First, in the first row, we have to write as it is the frequency 8. Then, second number, we have to add like this, 8 and 10. 8 and 10 is 18. We have to add 8 and 10, then we will get 18. The same way, next third row, and 18 plus 11 equal to 29. Then 29 plus 16 equal to 45. Then 45 plus 20 is equal to 65. 65 plus 25 is equal to 90. 90 plus 15 is equal to 105. 105 plus 9 is equal to 114. 114 plus 6 is equal to 120. This is the way we have to find the cumulative frequency. Then we have to find this total frequency, that is equal to 120. N equal to 120. This is even. So, we can apply that formula. M equal to 120 divided by 2 plus 120 divided by 2 plus 1th item divided by 2. That is equal to 60th plus 61st divided by 2. Then 60th item, we have to search find from the cumulative frequency. Here, see the cumulative frequency. Here, 60 lies in between 45 and 65. So, we have to take the greater value. So, in greater value, we have to find the X. So, the value is 24. The same way, 61. 61 also lies from 45 to 65. We have to take this greater value. Greater values, X only we are going to take. So, that value is 24. So, both the value 24 plus 24 divided by 2, that is equal to 48 divided by 2, that is equal to 24. This is the answer, median. Next type, continuous data. Find the median for the following data, class interval and frequency, solution. First, we have to find the cumulative frequency. Class interval, first two columns are given in the question, class interval and frequency. Third column, we have to find cumulative frequency. In the first for finding cumulative frequency, the first row we can write as it is. First frequency is 29, so here cumulative frequency also 29. Then next value we have to add this 29 and 195. Then 29 plus 195 is 224. Then next 224 plus 241 is 465. Then 465 plus 117 equal to 582. Then 582 plus 52 is equal to 634. Then 634 plus 10 is equal to 644. 644 plus 6 is equal to 650. 650 plus 3 is equal to 653. 653 plus 2 is equal to 655. Next, we have to find the total frequency. Total frequency is 655. Listen, ma, these two values must be equal. Next, we are going to find the median class. Median class formula, size of n by 2th item, 655 divided by 2. If we divide this, we will get 327.5th item. We have to find from the cumulative frequency, 327.5 lies between 224 and 465. We have to take the greater value. So, we can encircle this row. 10 to 15. This is the median class. Median class is equal to 10 to 15. Now, we must recall that formula. That formula m is equal to l plus n by 2 minus m divided by f into c. L is the lower limit of the median class. N is the total frequency. F is the frequency of the median class. M is the cumulative frequency of the pre-median class. And c is the class limit. Median class is equal to 10 to 15. Here, lower limit of the median class, that is L is equal to 10 and capital N is equal to 655, N by 2 is equal to 327.5 and M, small m is equal to the cumulative frequency of the pre-median class, so 224, and F is the frequency of the median class, 241, and C is the class size, 5. Then we can apply all the values in this formula. Median is equal to L plus N by 2 minus M divided by F into C. That is equal to L value is 10. 10 plus N by 2 value 327.5 minus M value is 224 divided by F value 241 into C value is 5. Then we can, if we simplify this, we'll get median value is equal to 12.1473. We can convert this into two digits. So 12.15, because the third digit is more than 5. So we can add 1, 2 here. So the answer is 12.15. Thank you, girls.